A very good day to all parents. We welcome you to today's activity under the Parents as Co-Educators program.
The activity for today is fun with puzzles. In this activity, the children will enhance their logical thinking and observation skills. We have covered two types of puzzles in today's activity. Let us begin with the first puzzle, which is join the dots. To begin this activity, ask the child to make dots at equal distance on a blank page in any notebook. There should be a minimum of 9 dots in the horizontal row and 13 dots in the vertical column. The parent can make the dots if the child finds it too difficult. Now, make the top left dot as shown in the figure as the start point for the activity. The parent will give certain directions to the child now to join the dots. You can either write down these directions in the notebook or you can instruct the child orally. Here in the demonstrated directions, D means down and U means up, R means right and L means left. A sample solution for this activity has been provided in the next slide. As the first direction in the previous slide was 2D. 2D implies 2 down. So the child must start from the starting point and move 2 steps in the downward direction and connect the dots accordingly. You can refer to the image displayed on the slide for understanding. Now, the next instruction is 1R, implying 1 right. So now the child moves 1 step in the right direction and connects the dots. Kindly refer to the image for understanding. After joining all the dots as per the given directions, the final image would look something like this. The parent can also change the directions and repeat this puzzle. Let us move on to the second puzzle for today, which is Sudoku. To begin this activity, ask the child to draw a big square and then draw 3 lines, both horizontally and vertically, to finally divide the square into 16 smaller squares. Next, darken the horizontal and vertical line which divide the bigger square into half respectively, the second line of the 3 lines drawn vertically and horizontally. You can refer the image shown in figure 1. Next, fill in the numbers in the respective boxes as shown in figure 2. This is a 4x4 Sudoku puzzle that they have to solve. This 4x4 Sudoku puzzle is solved by filling the rows and columns and the 4 smaller squares each with numbers 1 to 4 without repetition. To start with, we go with checking the rows. In the first row, only the number 3 is missing and the first square is empty. So, fill the first box with the number 3. Moving to the next row, 2 squares are empty, so we skip filling this row for now and move to the third row. In the third row, the third square is empty and number 1 is left out, so we place the number 1 in the third square. Hence, we have the numbers 1, 2, 3 and 4 in the third row. Coming to the fourth row, 2 squares are left over, so we can skip that row for now. Step 2. We now proceed with the columns. Starting with the first column, we can see that 1 is not present in it. So, we fill the number 1 in the fourth square of column 1, since it is empty. In the second column, also the number 1 is missing, and the second square is empty. So, we fill the second square with number 1. In the third and the fourth columns, the number 2 is missing, and the second and the fourth squares are empty respectively. So we fill number 2 in the empty squares in the third and the fourth column. Now, we can observe that the entire Sudoku puzzle has been filled up and hence it is solved. You can observe that each square of 4 units has the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 without repetition. Also, every row has the numbers 1, 2, 3 and 4 without repetition. The same applies for every column. We have provided 4 more Sudoku puzzles for you to solve with your child. The solution of the Sudokus presented in the previous slide are shown here. Once the activity has been completed, you can discuss the following questions with your student. Were they able to draw the patterns rightly? If not, where did they get confused? Was the child able to solve the Sudoku? If not, what was the difficulty the child faced? How did they fill the numbers? Row-wise, column-wise, or box-wise? Or they used all the three ways? After filling, did they check if they had done it rightly? If yes, how did they verify it? If not, you can ask them to verify the solution of their puzzle.
That is all for today's activity. We hope you and the child enjoyed it. We request you to send a photograph or a video of the child performing this activity. Also, in case of any doubts or suggestions, you could reach us out on our WhatsApp number provided on the screen. Thank you.